We've got the refreshed BMW X3 M40i.
Slight facelift to this car, still a great engine.
Giddy up. I love this engine. What is it, Andrea?
Wow.
What's under the hood?
A 3-liter turbocharged inline six with a new 48-volt hybrid system, an 8-speed automatic transmission, 382 horsepower, and 369 pound-feet of torque. Standard all-wheel drive, and you're going to have to put premium fuel in this SUV.
Now BMW, because they market this as an M40i, they do put in more standard performance features, but we're gonna find out later, they don't put more standard features in it. Let's go through that now.
The base trim comes with a 10.25-inch touchscreen and a 10.25-inch digital gauge display, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a heated steering wheel, power front seats with driver's seat memory, heated sports seats, a leatherette upholstery, front and rear park distance control, adaptive LED headlights, LED fog lights, 20-inch wheels, and run flat tires.
Andrea, I notice a new center console with new switches and buttons. What are we gonna put it in?
You gotta put it in S for subscribe, and if you can hit the notification bell, you'll be notified when all our reviews drop, and then you can watch them.
And we do this, the couple car review, twice a week. The first one drops on Wednesday.
We put another one out on Saturday.
So make sure you like, subscribe, hit that bell, but also follow along on Instagram. It's MotorMouth_Andrea. For me, it's MotorMouth_Auto, and the links are below. This video is brought to you by Canada Drives. Shop online for your next used vehicle and enjoy the convenience of 2-year door delivery and the confidence of a 7-day love it or return it guarantee. Visit canadadrives.ca to learn more. This is one of my favorites, Andrea.
It sure feels good. What a dynamic drive. It's so entertaining, but agile for an SUV. One thing I noticed, Zach, is the steering is a little bit lighter than I expected and I'm used to.
Well, they add in, as I mentioned just a moment ago, because this is an M40i, they add in more of the performance features, and this comes with a standard adaptive steering. So at low speed, you're gonna get that over-boosted feel, making it easy to maneuver.
Yeah.
But then when you get it on the highway, it tightens right up and it's gonna give you that feel that you typically like.
Yes, and also, if you go into settings, you can make those changes as well to make it feel a little bit heavier.
Now this is a facelifted model, this 2022 model. Some elements I like, some I'm not crazy about. You seem to like it.
Oh, I think they have done such a great job with this refresh. It is bolder and more modern looking.
And you know what it doesn't have? The big buck tooth grille that we're seeing in some of their other products. Yes. So thank you, BMW, for not making it look ridiculous. But the part I'm not loving, Andrea, are the rear lights. They kind of look like they were just bolted on.
Well, I love it all. I like the new LED headlights and tail lights. The LED headlights are about 10 millimeters lower than the outgoing model. It has a revised grille, 20-inch wheels. We've got 21-inch on here. We paid an extra $500
well,
for those.
We didn't pay anything, Andrea. They gave it to us for the week. What did we get for $500?
We get the 21-inch wheels.
All right. Now, what I like about this are the new exhaust finishers on the back. They're kind of square looking. I think that looks good.
I love this exterior color. It's called Tanzanite Blue Metallic. I think it looks gorgeous. Yeah, you also get new front and rear bumpers as well. So it really is just a slight redesign, a nice refresh.
And the inside, you would have to really know your BMW products to know there's really anything different in here.
Yeah.
And I've done 180 degrees on this, Andrea. I always used to say BMW doesn't change their interiors enough. You have all of these fancy screens and other brands, but having lived through a bunch of vehicles lately that are all touch screens and all of that kind of stuff, I'm really enjoying the classic way you interact with this car.
Yeah, sure. I mean, it has new climate control buttons, but they're buttons. And the center console now has some piano black, which I don't know.
We don't love.
I know people are not crazy about it, and neither are we. It comes with a 10.25-inch touchscreen and a 10.25-inch digital driver display. We have the BMW Cockpit Pro in here, so we've got the 12.3-inch touchscreen and digital driver display. I think it looks great.
So what you're telling me is you get the higher horsepower BMW X3 and the bigger screens aren't thrown in.
$1,200.
Oh my God. This is the whole problem with these legacy car brands, you get a new upstart like Genesis that comes in and you get their larger engine. You just get everything included.
Yep, for sure. But it gets worse, Zach. Are you ready for this?
I have my seatbelt on.
Great. So this comes with leatherette interior. It's a new product that...
Wait a second. How much does this cost?
This one, our test model, is $82,000, but just under $70,000 is what this starts at.
With the bigger engine, you get leatherette seats. Just let that sink in for a moment, friends.
Yes. Okay. So you can get the 30i and the 30e. They both come standard with leatherette seats. We upgraded to Vernasca leather in here for $1,500.
Well, we didn't upgrade. They just gave it to us for the week.
And if you want the merino leather, it's $3,000. Now, this is across the board on all X3 models. I've got a problem with that. This should come with the merino leather at no charge for the price point. Vernasca leather, to me, is really... feels like a leatherette, although BMW says it is leather.
This is cheap looking leather. It's cheap feeling leather. It doesn't look like what you expect. You know, I just can't believe that you're paying a huge amount of money, over 70 G's to get the upgraded engine. Those sorts of things, like you said, well, at least it should come with this. You know, and then if you want to get the merino leather on top, that's an extra package for $1,200.
Yeah.
But to put vinyl pleather seats in your high performance version, I think that is just like, come on, this is ridiculous.
This is around $14,000 more than the 30i, and you get the leatherette. I just don't get it.
Yeah, I don't get it either. And then you get to the bottoms of the doors. You've got the crunchy hard plastic. BMW used to be really good at this. They used to have all the soft touch materials on the bottom, and they've cheapened out on some of their cars. This is one of them. This. Honestly, the interior in this looks like it should be in, other than the bigger screens, in the base Model X.
Yeah, this needs an upgrade for sure. Even if you want
it ventilated. It just was upgraded. That's the whole thing that's crazy.
If you want ventilated front seats, that'll cost you another $900. And heated rear seats is $400. We have a package. It's called the Premium Enhanced Package. That's where you'll find the head-up display, panoramic sunroof, ambient lighting, comfort access, these sorts of features. And that's $7,900. So this adds up really fast.
Now, the back seat of the X3 is well designed. It's one of the bigger in this class. They have a bit of a recline to the rear seats. This is actually bigger than the original X5. Can you believe that?
I know.
What are the numbers?
It offers 36.4 inches of space back there. The XC60 from Volvo, as well as the Acura RDX, has more.
Now, what about carry-on and a cooler?
Well, it really ate up our carry-on and a cooler. There is so much space back there, not best in class. It's the GV70 that offers more, but overall cargo capacity is excellent. Again, it's just the Volvo XC60 that has more.
And we get into the questions now in this spendy product.
Time now for questions, coffee, and cars.
Your questions from Instagram.
When I test drove this 2 years ago, I loved it. But the deal breaker for me was the computerized exhaust pops. It was the same recording every time. It was not natural. It drove me crazy. Have they changed it? Yes, well, now you can go in and it's based on drive mode. So if you put it in Sport Plus, for example, yes, it's loud and you kind of hear everything, right? But you put it in comfort and it really quiets things down.
I think he's also referring to the fact that they piped in the sound in through the stereo system, not hearing it as much with this.
No.
And it's noisy outside. Like when Andrew is driving by, you can hear it. But inside, depends, as Andrew mentioned, which mode you're in.
What's your impression of driving dynamics comparing it to the Genesis GV70 with the V6 engine? You can't beat the prestige of BMW, but Genesis has put out a very nice product.
Well, this is one of my favorites in this category. I would say for handling and fun to drive and engine, I would give Macan S or GTS the advantage with their 2.9 liter turbo, fantastic motor. Then it would go to this. It's got a lot of character. That's the one thing I said to Andrea, it's been a long time since we've driven this, is it's got a lot of character and you kind of learn where the power is and it comes on in a surge, it sounds good. You know, the Genesis product I think is excellent, but this inline six-cylinder engine from BMW is one of the best engines ever made, full stop, period.
Yeah, I agree. Love this engine. Also love the Macan S in GTS. That would be my first choice. But I agree with Zach. The GV70 is a great product. It offers a smooth ride, a comfortable cabin, but it also feels dynamic as well. Mm-hmm. But I would take this just for driving over the GV70. Can you get cruise control with stop and go on the M40i in 2022? How about the upgraded Harman Kardon sound system? Seems to be missing from the 2021 model. Yes, you can. You can get both. The cruise control stop and go is available in the driver assistance package for $2,000. And the Harman Kardon sound system is in the package that we have, the premium enhanced package, which is $7,900.
You're getting the rain package for free. It's been pouring rain.
It just doesn't stop raining in Vancouver.
The one thing I will say is there's an asterisk next to all of these because of the chip shortage. Car companies are having to take things out of cars just to keep cars coming off the line and getting delivered to people who need a new car. So you're going to have to check with your dealer because week to week, month to month, there might be something that's omitted from a car because they just can't make it, really.
Yes, and this one doesn't come with the wireless charger because it's not available because of the chip shortage. And we've also heard from followers who have ordered an X5 and they're saying no wireless charger and no touchscreen on it.
But you have the iDrive controller. It's not the end of the world, but if you're a touch sensitive person, you want to use the screen, that could be a deal breaker.
For sure.
And now it's time for our hot topic. What's this one, Andrea?
Wowza, it looks terrific. Given the onslaught of HEVs, PHEVs, and EVs, do you think the demand for these pure ICE vehicles will start to wane, especially when 5.5 seconds 0 to 60 times for vehicles like the ID4?
Well, they're slowly adding electrification. This has the mild hybrid, the 48-volt system really is just enhanced auto start-stop. But you're going to see more of that in the BMW lineup. In fact, the base model of the 3 Series is a hybrid, or plug-in hybrid, right?
Yeah, the 30E. Now, I didn't feel like I gave up a lot of the driving dynamics that I feel in the 30i with the 30E. It had a lot of power, and that torque from the electric motor sure felt great. The only problem with it is it just doesn't offer enough range.
Well, that's something they have to adjust. Obviously, they're going to see more range out of these plug-in hybrids, which is one of the things I always talk about. Mm-hmm. So you're buying today technology isn't future-proof. No. And what does that do to resale value of the cars that only have 28 kilometers of range when the next one maybe has 50 and the one after that 75? That's one of the problems. You get into this refresh cycle. Where do you jump in?
And I also think, you know, some people will just want this high-performance vehicle. The M40i really has a special engine, and some just won't want to give that up. Others will. They want an electrified vehicle, whether it's an EV like the ID4 that you mentioned that has a very quick time, or something even like a Taycan, you know, where you're going to spend a fortune.
But let's just talk about the elephant in the room. It's the new BMW full electric cars, like their SUV. It's got to be one of the ugliest things I've seen. So if you put this next to that, I would guarantee you, just based on looks, most people would take this. And then you add in the fact that how long are we going to be able to get these cars?
I know.
Right? Is this going to be gone in 5 years or 10 years?
So
there's going to be people that will say, I'll take this now because I love the engine. I like the way it looks. And hopefully BMW will change the design language of those new electric cars. I don't know. You guys write below what you think. I think it looks a little bit like a clown car.
Yeah, I think that maybe they go too far with a futuristic look. And that's one of the things I like about the new Volkswagen ID4 is that it does have a slight futuristic look, but it just maybe looks a little bit more modern and something that you might find in a gas model.
Well, while we're at it, let's get into what else you can get in the high-performance SUV game.
For your consideration, 4 vehicles for you to consider.
Up first is the Mercedes-Benz AMG GLC 43 with a 3-liter twin-turbo V6. 385 horsepower and a starting price of $65,500.
Next is the GV70 with the larger 3.5-liter twin-turbocharged V6. 375 horsepower and a starting price of $68,500.
The Audi SQ5 has a 3-liter turbocharged V6. 349 horsepower and a starting price of just over $66,000.
Here's our used car alternative from CanadaDrives.ca. We chose a 2017 Porsche Macan base model with 54,503 kilometers for $47,990. Click on the tab or the link in the description below to find more vehicles in this category from CanadaDrives.ca. So there are four high-performance SUVs for you to consider. Now, we've already talked about this thing is expensive, so let's get into the price, the warranty, the fuel economy. What are we going to start with?
Let's start with pricing. The base model starts at just under $70,000, and price as tested is just over $82,000. There are no J.D. Power ratings for the X3 M40i, but the 2021 model gets an overall score of 80 out of 100. CarEdge states a BMW X3 will retain 47% of its value after 5 years. Here's the fuel economy. It gets 11.3 liters per 100 kilometers in the city, 8.7 on the highway. That's 21 miles per gallon city, 26 miles per gallon highway. The towing capacity is 4,400 pounds, and BMW offers a warranty of 4 years or 80,000 kilometers, 50,000 miles, plus no charge scheduled maintenance for 4 years.
Lightning round, two things we like to see improve.
I love this engine. It is just so special.
And the handling is really top notch.
What I'd like to see is a more luxurious interior, BMW. I want to see some nice leather in here.
And the performance model should have more standard features, kind of carrying on what Andrea just said.
Engaging, lively, and entertaining. What gets better than this drive?
They could improve the interior. They certainly could work on that. But if you can afford this vehicle with this engine, you won't be disappointed.
This video is brought to you by Canada Drives. Shop online for your next used vehicle and enjoy the convenience of to-your-door delivery and the confidence of a 7-day love-it-or-return-it guarantee. Visit CanadaDrives.ca to learn more.